Hello and welcome to this answer video regarding the double glazed window problem. My name is Anne and I'm one of the TAs in this MOOC on transport phenomena. What I always do when I have to answer a question is that I start with writing down some data from the question itself. So for instance, I wrote down that 1 year equals 2 × 10⁷ heating seconds, and that the temperature difference between the inside and the outside of the glass is always 10 Kelvin or 10 degrees Celsius on average. Furthermore, the exterior heat transfer coefficient on the inside and the outside of the glass are equal, and they are 20 watts per meter square Kelvin, while the conductivity of glass is 1 watt per meter Kelvin and the thickness of a single glass pane is 3 millimeters. The thermal conductivity of air is given as 0.025 watt per meter Kelvin, and the thickness of air is given as 5 millimeters. And note that I put the thicknesses in meters because that is the SI unit, and that will make sure I don't make any mistakes with the units later on. On the bottom you see I calculated the cost in euros per joule, which is what I need later on in order to calculate the advantage of using double glazed windows. Now, moving on to question one. Transfer coefficient of a single glass plate. That is what is to be calculated. I'll start with a drawing with a glass plate with air on both sides. The air has a heat transfer coefficient on the outside and on the inside, and the glass has a thickness, dG for glass, and the thermal conductivity, I love the G for glass as well. We know that for the total heat transfer coefficient, we have to use reciprocal addition. So 1 over u single equals 1 over h on the outside plus 1 over h of the glass itself plus 1 over h on the inside. H on the outside and h on the inside are known. They are 20 watts per meter squared Kelvin. The h of the glass equals the conductivity of the glass divided by the thickness of the glass. Plugging in all the numbers, we get u single equals 1 over 20 plus 3 × 10⁻³ divided by 1, which is 1 over h glass, plus 1 over 20 and the entire thing to the power minus 1. This equals 9.7 watts per meter squared Kelvin. Alright, moving on to question number 2. How much energy is lost through the single glass panes on a yearly basis while the heating is turned on? And the answer is requested in units of energy per meter squared, so per surface area. Well, Newton's laws of cooling teaches us that the heat flux through a surface is given as U times delta T, where U is what we calculated in the previous question, and delta T is given as 10 Kelvin. However, this is the heat flux, and the units of this are watts per meter squared. However, we want something of the units of joules per meter squared. So we need to multiply by the time, which the time that we are going to use is the time, is the amount of heating seconds that is in a year. That's given as 2 × 10⁷. So our E equals phi Q, the double dash, times T, which equals U times delta T times small t. And this is 9.7 watts per meter squared Kelvin multiplied by 10 Kelvin multiplied by 2 × 10⁷ seconds. If you check the units, you will see that the Kelvins cross out and the seconds in combination with the watts gives us joule. So this indeed is what we need. The answer is 1.94 × 10⁹ joules per meter squared. Moving on to question number 3. Now we're going to talk about the double glazed window. So we start with the drawing again. We have air on the outside, then a window pane, then air on the inside, another window pane, and then the air in the inside of the building. Again, we have a lambda for the glass, for both panes. For the layer in between the glass panes, we have the lambda as well. Lambda A for lambda air. And we have a diameter, so the distance. The DA is the thickness of the air layer. Again, we have the thickness of the glass planes. And we have the inside and the outside heat transfer coefficients. Now, for the total, again, we use the reciprocal addition. So 1 over U double equals 1 over H on the outside plus 1 over H of the glass plus 1 over H of the air layer in between. I call it HA for air. Another glass pane, 1 over H for the glass. And again, the inside heat transfer coefficient. Now we know for the glass, it equals the lambda of glass divided by the thickness of the glass. And we also use that equation for the air in between the glass panes. So lambda for air divided by the thickness of air. Again, the HI and the HO, so the inside and the outside heat transfer coefficients are known. We've calculated HG and we calculated H for air. So we should be good to go. Plugging in all the numbers, this is what we get. And this gives us the final answer, which is 3.27 watts per meter squared Kelvin. In the fourth question, we are asked how much energy is lost through the double glass panes on a yearly basis while the heating is turned on. And here we use the same calculations as before. So we use the energy equals phi q double dash times the time, which is u times delta t multiplied by the time. U is what we calculated before, which is 3.27 watts per meter squared Kelvin. The delta t is still the same, which is 10 Kelvin. And the time is the amount of heating seconds in a year, which was given as 2 multiplied by 10 to the power of 7 seconds. The calculation gives us 6.5 times 10 to the power of 8 joules per meter squared, which is significantly lower than what we had before for the single glass panes. Question 5 asks us what the total surface area should be for the double glass windows to be economically better. First, we calculate how much energy we save per year, and then we multiply that by the cost of the energy, and then we know how much we can save per year. So, the amount of energy we save per year is the single minus the double of the energy loss, which is, as we remember, 1.94 times 10 to the power of 9 joules per meter squared minus 6.5 multiplied by 10 to the power of 8 joules per meter squared. This gives us 129 times 10 to the power of 7 joules per meter squared, which is what we save. And dividing this by the cost per joule gives us how much money we save per meter squared. So we have 11 cents, so 0.11 euros per 10 to the power of 7 joule. When we multiply this with 129 times 10 to the power of 7 joules per meter squared, we get the savings per meter squared, in euros per meter squared. We can see that the 10 to the power of 7 drops out immediately. Joules do as well. So we end up with 0.11 euros multiplied by 129 per meter squared. This gives us 14.17 euros per meter squared, which is what we save. However, the fixed costs are 2,000 euros higher when we use double glazed windows, so we need to save more than 2,000 euros. And the question was, how much surface area do we need? Well, in order to calculate that, we use 2,000 euros divided by 14.17 euros per square meter. This gives us a little over 141 meters squared, which is 141.15 meters squared. But we could only use integer amounts of area, so we need at least 142 meters squared in order for the double glass to be an economically viable option. This is the end of this answer video. I hope you enjoyed it and it made things a little more clear for you. Thank you for listening.